गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक बेंचमार्किंग। सो फर्स्ट आई हैव टू नो what is the benchmarking. So benchmarking is a strategic approach of evaluating a set of customer focus organizational processes. Okay, so benchmarking is nothing but a strategic approach. It is related to the strategic management. So of evaluating a set of customer focused organizational processes, so it is mainly focused on customer related processes which are involved in the organization process. So what are the processes are related to the customer base, we have to focus and evaluate on these things, that is nothing but benchmarking. So organizational processes, activities and products or services with other internal business units and externally with corporate entities in the same industry or in the broader marketplace. So what are the organizational process and activities related to customer and products based on customer taste and services based on customer orientation. So with other internal business units, so and externally with corporate entities in the same industry. So you have to evaluate the internal business units and also external corporate entities. Those are nothing but external companies extra which are in the same industry. Okay, suppose if you are taking a telecom industry, then the remaining companies, so Jio, suppose you are a Jio company and the remaining three companies, you have to evaluate these three companies also like this. Okay, so that is benchmarking. So as a strategic management tool, benchmarking exercises provide the why and how behind an organization's advantages and disadvantages with the targeted competitor measures and industry best practices. Okay, so as a strategic management tool, so benchmarking is a strategic management tool. So benchmarking exercises provide the why and how behind an organization. Okay, so why and how, that means why, for what purpose it is required, and how, so how you are implementing. So these two are mainly focused on benchmarking. Okay, so why and how. ఓకే సో జనరల్గా అంటాం కదండి ఎందుకు ఎలా అంటాం కదా సో లైక్ దట్ ఓకే సో జస్ట్ లైక్ దట్ సో వై అండ్ హౌ బిహైండ్ అన్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్స్ సో అడ్వాంటేజెస్ అండ్ డిసడ్వాంటేజెస్ విత్ టార్గెటెడ్ కాంపిటీటర్స్ మేజర్స్ అండ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఫైండ్ అవుట్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద అడ్వాంటేజెస్ అండ్ డిసడ్వాంటేజెస్ విత్ టార్గెటెడ్ కాంపిటీటర్స్ సో సపోజ్ దేర్ ఆర్ ఫైవ్ కంపెనీస్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ సపోజ్ సేమ్ ప్రొడక్ట్స్ are manufacturing already there in the market, so you are the one of that. So then who is the potential competitor, that means who gives heavy competition in the market, that is nothing but he is nothing but targeted competitor. So you have to identify this this targeted competitor and what are the advantages and disadvantages with the competitor measures, targeted competitor measures, and industry best practices. And what are the, suppose in industry some of the best practices are there, suppose some people are giving good quality services and best pricing, so all these there. So according to that, so you have to find out what are the advantages are and the disadvantages came from targeted competitor measures and also best practices. So the outcome is identifying the correct next steps to streamline. So then you have to, after evaluating all these things, then you getting an outcome of the evaluation, then with that outcome you have to identifying what are the next steps you have to take for correction purpose. So how you are correcting the problems in the benchmarking and the strategy. So leverage and exploit business process and supporting activities. So in all the activities, that means business processes and also supporting activities, so you have to take corrective actions, product and services also, and thereby driving improved revenue, profitability, and profitability. So then in this way, we have to improve our revenue and profitability. So revenue means income and profitability means profit. Okay. So you are getting both of them with the use of benchmarking exercise. Okay. So then the purpose of benchmarking is to identify, redefine, and create innovative concepts for improving processes and supporting technologies. So you are using benchmarking to identify and redefine and create an innovative concepts. So new concepts for improving processes, you have to improve the process, business processes, and also supporting technologies. Then you have to support the new technologies and also reduce waste and cost. So you have to reduce the waste and also you have to reduce the cost and decrease market risk and exposure. So you have to decrease the risk in the market. That means every time there is a risk in the market, but anyway, you have to reduce the risk in the market also. So and exposure. Okay. So and increase profitability. Ultimate goal is you have to improve the profitability and streamline and enrich customer fulfillment and loyalty in interactions. And after that, streamlining the customer fulfillment. That means what the customer is desired from our product and what the customer is expecting from our product and loyalty interactions. And after that, there is a loyalty interactions. That means I have to try to improve loyalty of the customer. That means those who are strictly bind to purchase our products, that means they are loyal customers. So there is no any deviation. They trust our brand. So you give that assurance and you have to give that much support to the customer. Okay. So the customer is always trust on you, but you are also take responsibility to continue trust and support to the customer. Okay. So and management professionals also view it as an essential tool to support continuous improvement and total quality initiatives, including Six Sigma. So Six Sigma is also a contemporary management concept. So these are the advanced one. So the management people are professionals are also feels the benchmarking is a essential tool support continuous improvement. That means improvement is continuous. There is no breaking. There is no break in improvement process. So it is continuous process. And total quality initiatives, then you have to take the total initiatives for quality. So because you are giving a good quality product, then only there is a repetitive customers and there is a repeat purchases. So otherwise, nobody is interested to buy your product because you are not giving a good quality product. Then ultimately it leads to customer dissatisfaction and the customer is shifted to another manufacturer or another product. Okay. So and Six Sigma is also one of the quality control related to the one of the quality control concept. So that is an important one. So this is actually developed by Japan in the Japan. So they are using Six Sigma for improving quality and standards of the product. So that means there is no defects in the product. So always they want to try the products to the customer without any defects. Okay. So the main motto of that company. So I think Toyota. I think Toyota. Okay. So Toyota is the company. So the benchmarking. The Six Sigma is also used for quality improvement and you are giving best quality product to the customers. Okay, so that's it. Then definition of the benchmarking. So benchmarking is the process of comparing and measuring your organization against others anywhere in the world to gain information on philosophies, practices and measures that will help your organization take action to improve its performance. Benchmarking gathers the tactic knowledge, the know-how, judgments, and enablers that explicit knowledge often misses. Okay, so benchmarking is the process of comparing and measuring your organization against others. Okay, so this is the process is used for comparing and measuring your organization against others. That means you are always comparison your company performance with your competitors company, those who are closely related to competition. That means those who are giving competition to you. Okay, so then only so that is very very important thing. So you have to compare your company performance with your competitors. That means those who are giving a heavy competition. Okay, that means the major competitor for your company, then you have to compare with that company performance. Okay, so what type of technologies they are following, what type of philosophies they are following, what type of practices they are following, what type of the performances they are showing. So you have to compare all these aspects. Okay, suppose that means everything. Okay, financial related issues and non-financial related issues, performance based issues and policy issues and process issues. What are that? So technological issues, everything have to compare with your competitors company. Okay, so that is very very important. So after that you are getting awareness. That means you are identifying where you are and where the lag is there and where the problems are there. So after comparison you are evaluating so your strengths and weaknesses and other your competitors' strengths and weaknesses and what are the opportunities they have and what are the opportunities you have and what are the threats they have and what are the threats you have. So then you have to analysis all these things. Okay, that means that is nothing but SWOT analysis. Already we have discussed. Okay, so SWOT, you have to perform SWOT analysis on both the companies. Then after that you have to find out all these things. Then you have to list out what you are finding after evaluating the after comparison the two companies. Then you have to conclude where you are strong and where you are in weak and where you are how the opportunities are came from that company and how the opportunities are came to you and what are the threats are related to your company and what are the threats related to that company. So and how they are overcome and what type of strategies they have to follow and what is the vision of that company and what is your vision and what is the objectives of that company and what is the objectives of your company. So and each and everything you have to comparison. Okay, then try to improve your performance comparison with to your competitor performance. That means your competitor is in better performance, better position in their performance, then you have to try to reach them. Okay, so or else you are the good one. Suppose you are showing the good performance and they are not showing that much performance, then you are okay, so there is no problem at all. Okay, so you have to know these things after comparison only, after benchmarking process only. Okay, so after that then only you have to know you are the good and your competitor is the good in good position. So then this process is required for every type of the organization. So benchmarking gathers the tactic knowledge, the know-how, so how we are going on and at judgments. So what are the decisions you have to take in and enablers that explicit knowledge often misses. Okay, so and after that enablers the explicit knowledge often misses. That means what are the knowledge you have to miss and what type of knowledge you have to you are getting out of this. So then you have to know all these things. Okay, so how to overcome this and how to take the decisions and how to make the judgments and how to get the explicit knowledge where you are missing. So you have to know all these things. Okay, so this is done through benchmarking. Okay, so then benchmarking types and categories. Okay, so benchmarking types and categories. So what are the types in the benchmarking? So this is also important one. So benchmarking can be internal, comparing performance between different business units or teams. So that means benchmarking is the is also done in within the organization also. That means department to department, that means finance department with marketing department and marketing department with HR department, then you have to done this also, and also in between teams also. Okay, and also external or external comparing performance companies in a target industry or across multiple sectors. So benchmarking process is not only related to external and both internal and external. So internally you have to comparison different teams and different business units and different departments. So come to external, then you have to comparison with your targeted customer, targeted competitor. Okay, so then you have to comparison with your target competitor. So within the broader types, there are four categories of benchmarking. So there are four types of benchmarkings are there. So competitive benchmarking, functional benchmarking, generic benchmarking, internal benchmarking. Okay, so what is the competitive benchmarking? So competitive, when coming into competitive benchmarking, direct competitor to competitor comparison of a product, services, process or method. So you are directly comparison with product which is offered by your competitor, and the service which is offered by your competitor, and the process process done by your competitor, and what are the methods followed by your competitor. So then you have to comparison between all these things, product to product, service to service, process to process, and method to method. Have to comparison in these four areas, focused on these four areas. So that is called as competitive benchmarking. So second one is functional benchmarking. So functional benchmarking is comparison to similar business practices with the same or similar functions outside the organization's target industry. So similar business practices with the same business or similar functions, okay, which are done by outside companies or target industry, that is nothing but called as functional benchmarking. So and after that, generic benchmarking. So generic benchmarking is broadly conceptualizes unconnected business processes or functionality in the same or similar ways despite the industry. Okay, so it is broadly conceptualizes unconnected business processes, that means those who are not connected with another, the business process or functionality in the same. So that means functionality is in the same, but they are unconnected or similar ways despite the industry. Okay, so I have to conceptualize all these things, that is called as generic benchmarking. So after that, internal benchmarking. So what is the internal benchmarking is comparison of a business process to a similar process with one or more business units inside the organization. So I have to comparison business process to a similar process with one or more business units inside the organization. That means internal benchmark means within the internal business units, you have to comparison with one business unit to another business unit. That means one or more, that means you have to comparison with one with two or three or four. So that depends upon your choice. You have to comparison any number of business units. There is no problem at all. That is called as internal benchmarking. Okay. So these are the four types of benchmarking processes: competitive benchmarking, functional benchmarking, generic benchmarking, and internal benchmarking. So after that, so what are the key performance indicators in the benchmarking process? These are very, very important. So you have to know key performance indicators. That means these are the indicators are indicate the what are the key performances in the benchmarking process. Then I am trying to give some examples of KPIs. So I am not going for in depth, because it is also a 200 pages book, benchmarking process. So that's why I am giving outlines only. So according to your syllabus, that is enough. So cost effectiveness, cycle time, growth rate, headcount optimization, process efficiency, staff productivity. So what are the key performance indicators in the benchmarking process are? First one is cost effectiveness. That means always you are trying to reduce the production cost of the product or cost of production. Then only you are getting the good profit. Okay. So that's why the first key performance indicator is cost effectiveness. So what you have to plan, and then first you have to plan the cost. So what is the cost of that process or something? So suppose you want to acquire a new technology. So then what is the cost of that new technology? And that means what is the price of that new technology? So and how much it is benefited and how much suppose how the value of the technology, so how much how it is useful, and what range, suppose what type of benefits you have to get after implementing this technology. So that means you have to put some investment on that, then you are getting the same value what you have to invest on that product, or suppose on the technology, then you are get it back. So the value after investing there on something, suppose on after investing on technology, some amount you have to invest it. So you are getting the same value what you are investing, how much amount you have to investing, then you are getting the back, that means return on investment. So the value you have to return. Okay, that is very, very important thing. So then after that cycle time means suppose there is a production process, there is a cycle time, again come back. So then how much time to take complete the production process, so that is also one of the important factor. And after that growth rate, so in growth, that means growth rate means it indicates the development of the organization, that means productivity you have to improve, and also you have to improve the 100%. Suppose you have to utilize all the resources in optimized level, that means you are utilizing all the resources in 100%. Okay, so always trying, then ultimately you are getting the good profit, then also your growth rate is also in improving. So and then headcount optimization. So headcount optimization means, so how many people are required, so how many people are doing that work, so that is important thing. So headcount optimization, that means you are always reducing the manpower, that means requirement is enough. So then you have to optimize, that means how many people are required for that job, then you have to allot that much only, so not excess or not less. Okay, so that is headcount optimization. So suppose they for that purpose they are required 10 number of people, then you are assigned the 10 number of people, you are allocated the 10 number of people that work, so not greater than or not less than. Okay, so that is headcount optimization. And process efficiency, so process efficiency means how the process is going on, so in efficient manner or not, that is process efficiency. And after that staff productivity, so the productivity of the staff, it is a good position or not, that means how much how many units they are producing, each and every person. Suppose each and every person they are producing, they are manufacturing 10 products per day, so that is the productivity of that staff. Okay, so you have to improve the productivity of the staff always. Okay, but you have to maintain the quality, that is also important. So you have to give the importance to the quality. So without quality, how many number of products manufactured, that is not a good one. So the defected products is there, and the more number of defected products are there, then what is the use of your productivity? So that's why you have to focus the improvement of the productivity. So, and also you have to maintain the standards and quality also. So both you have to give priority. Okay, so that is important one. So these are the examples of key performance indicators. So after that, so benchmarking the process. Okay, so benchmarking the process. So after that, you have to discuss about the process of the benchmarking. So today I'm giving only outline. So tomorrow we'll complete the remaining topic. So today it is not completed. So time is not enough. So benchmarking the process. So the typical benchmarking process consists of a set of structured steps as outlined below. So this is the common scenario of the benchmarking process. So for every type of organization, the common process is there. Okay, so this is not changed in organization. So within the process, within the steps, there is a change. But specifically, there is no change in the benchmarking process. Okay, this is the standardized process. So organizations need to tailor the steps for total alignment with their unique business purpose and requirements for conducting benchmarking events. So every organization have to maintain these steps and also alignment with their unique business purpose and requirements, and also they are align the unique business purpose for the purpose of unique business and requirements for conducting benchmarking events. Okay, so then so benchmarking process, so this is done by top level management. So there are five steps in this benchmarking process. So one is planning, and second one is setup, third one is collect, and fourth one is analyze, and fifth one is improve. Okay, so before you are going to anything, then you have to plan. First you have to make a plan and ready a plan for that. So how we are going to in this process, so what is the plan, so what you have to consider, and what are the requirements you have to need. So then you have to find out and make a plan. So that means up to ending, so up to improve, the last step you have to plan before. Okay, so that is nothing but planning, that is important phase. And after that setup, you have to set up the benchmarking process. So what are the requirements you have to need, then you have to set up all these things, what are the requirements to do this process. So and after that you have to collect the information for the purpose of benchmarking process. So and after that analyze, you have to analyze. So what you have to collect, what you are collected, suppose what information you have to collected already, then you have to analyze all these information. So and comparison, done comparison, that is also important one, and also final improve. So you have to improve, then is there any improvements needed, then you have to go for improvement. So then you have to again go to section plan. So this is the benchmarking process. This is common for every type of organization, what type of product they are producing, there is no problem at all, and what type of services they are offered, and what type of process they are following, so there is no issue at all. So is there any type of all these things, then it is adapted. Okay, so because it is only a tool of comparison, that means you have to analyze, so what you are and what you are competitor. Okay, so for that purpose only we are doing this process, benchmarking, so not else in anything. So it is a very simple thing you have to understand, and every management people, those who are learning management, they must know about the balance scorecard and benchmarking. So today so many companies are going to done this process in real. Okay, so it is not a textbook concept, so these two are regularly practiced by management people, so really applicable in all type of organizations. So then you have to know all these things. Okay, so it is very very important topics. So in your syllabus, suppose in R20, sorry R19 syllabus, newly included these two things. Okay, before R16 and R13 and before, so these concepts are not included in the strategic management. Okay, so you have to learn these new things, so that is more benefited to you. Okay, so I think all of you understand this benchmarking process up to what I am discussing today. So the remaining part is discussed in tomorrow's class. Okay, thank you all.